Over the last 4 years, we have been producing different stories on human interest issues that happen in our society. As we celebrate our 100 journals, in this episode, our reporters are looking back at their favorite stories and why they resonate with them. My name is Usla Akinyi, a reporter with African Slum Journal. My favorite journal is The Drug Menace because this is something that is real and it's happening everywhere. Drugs is really affecting people. Yeah, and getting the subject courier was not an easy thing because most of the time we could go there and we could not find him. And for that, because of the effects the drugs had on him, his sister actually had to do the talking on his behalf. We achieved something because even on my social media, I got people talking about it and the comments were also there that it was a good journal and it would bring a positive change to people.
My favorite journal is The Deaf Rapper. And this is one of my favorite journals because, first of all, when I heard about a deaf rapper, at first I thought, how can it happen that somebody who is deaf is rapping?
I was born hearing, and then I became sick. My dream has always been to become a musician. Growing up, I would see on the TV different musicians having different songs.
Through African Slum Journal, this guy actually got an opportunity to do a collabo with a well-known artist here in the country.
I was going through our website and my favorite journal is If Tomorrow Comes. I love the journal because it mostly touches on the society of Kenyan people. Mostly we don't do savings, and me as an accountant, I was touched because I never used to save any money.
Mzee yangu na yeye hakukua na save kitu. Kwanza tulikuwa tunaona bank, hata ujui bank ni nini.
My name is Thomas Onyego, and my favorite journal is The Green Gold. I shot this journal because I saw how the burning of Meraa affected the slum youth, especially in my area, Majengo slums.
Sasa venye waliban kwenda ngambo, kuna namba kubwa sana ya vijana, wengi sana, almost 200,000 walikosa kazi. Na hata fiki naongea, kuna kama 40 wameshapigwa marisasi washakuwa waizi.
My favorite journal is Aborted Dreams. It reminds me of the life my surrounding in the slums, like people giving up in life. But there's one girl in the journal called Emily Mora. She got pregnant in slums. She got pregnant, she was by then 15 years old. So when Emily Mora decided to tell the parents and the boyfriend about her pregnancy, everybody rejected Emily Mora. She remained like a disgrace to the community.
Before nipate boat, nilikuwa nafika na baba mtoto. Nikafika mali sa nikapata hiyo boat nikamsho. Alianza kukataa lakini nilifika mali akaanza kukataa ati ni uongo sina boat. Niliamua kurudi shule juu nisome. Labda nipate sati nipate job poa nisaidie mtu hii.
I was born and raised up in Dandora slum. Dandora is a home of the biggest dumping site called Boma. We used to scavenge hair whips. We come and wash them and reuse them again. Because for me, I really like changing hair. I really like having a different style. And that is also, that is what's happening to many women, especially in Africa. They like different hairstyles.
Hizo mpya zinakuanga na nini na bei kali kama 500 but hizi 150 kika after 2 weeks nikitoa hizi alafu nakuja kushukua tena.
Over the last 4 years we produced 99 stories of human interest, talking about health, talking about
the elderly in our society. The most story that I like of all is the tin latrine.
Yes, the people from the slum are just doing that, reusing the tin, not as anything else, but as a latrine right inside their houses.
Personally, we used to have a tin in the house whereby we put it under the bed and then in the night we use it as our latrine.
The people are forced to shun the toilets at night. Therefore, they opt for an alternative.
And I've been watching it over and over again because I lived through it and I can resonate with it. And most of these stories that we tell, people can resonate with them. And that's why for me, tin latrine is very special.